What? Take your shoes off, Rosie.
Why? Why?
Well, why do you think? I've just cleaned up. Shana will be back in a bit.
So?
Well, duh. I want everything to be nice and perfect. Where are you going with that milk? I might need that for Shan.
What, are you going to make her a rice pudding? We've got loads anyway. What's the big deal? She's not been away that long.
Yeah, well, it's long enough for me. You know, I feel like every day has been wasted time. And, like, my life's stalled and then it's getting back together. And oh, do you ever feel like that when Jason's not around?
No. Is Mum about?
No, she's gone to lunch with Jeff.
Oh, right. We're all taking it very calmly.
Yeah, what do you want to do, Rosie? Go and pick at the restaurant. Look, all I'm bothered about now is seeing Sian.
All right, well, what crappy style. See you later, you loser.
Cheers.
Wonder what's going on over there?
Oh, I missed you.
Same.
Tan on you.
Oh, yeah, no, like I've been tanning every tiny towel in Weatherfield.
Well, I've cooked you something nice to eat so we can stay in if you want. The best of it is we've got the house all to ourselves.
Audrey, is everything okay?
Yes, everything's fine, love. Thank you.
Well, it depends on your definition of fine. I don't know.
Honestly, it was amazing. I had the best time.
Sounds like it.
And we used to go to this souk, it's like market, every single day for a cup of sweet mint tea with this burger king. And then my mum got into bartering. She made such a show of it. I did get you a present.
She didn't completely forget about me then.
No, I have left at my mum's. Sorry.
Did you not get boring being me mum 24/7?
No. I went off on my own sometimes, right? And I met this girl, Chloe. She's so funny. And it's such a laugh. I'll let you say hello next time, Escaper. Anyway, listen to me going on about my holiday at fair. What have you been up to?
Waiting for you, but that's going to sound really pathetic now, isn't it?
No. I think it's dead sweet.
Yeah, well, anyway, I've cleaned your room and I've put some fresh flowers on your dressing table and got you a scented candle.
Oh, that's lovely, thank you.
Okay, we can go up after we've had this if you want.
Oh, sorry, babe, I'm not stopping tonight.
Why not?
Because my mum's expecting me.
Yeah, but we've only just got back off holiday with her.
Yeah, I know, but I'm just, like, so much closer now. And since we've been on holiday, we've had time to, like, proper talk.
Okay. It was only a few months ago that she was chucking you out, couldn't stand the sight of you.
No, she never.
Yeah, she did. Choosing some flipping loser boyfriend over you.
So, why are you being such a cow? I thought you'd be pleased for me.
Yeah, well, how can I be, Shan? You're leaving me.
No, I'm not. I am so not. We're still going to be together, just not tonight.
See, and there's me thinking that this is your old man. Here with me. Seems you can't even wait to get away.
Mum.
I saw your mum before. I'll miss you. Good neighbours are out to come by.
Why are you moving?
We're not.
Oh, I'm sorry, love. I...
Someone had sold the house from underneath us.
I don't know the ins and outs. I'm sorry. Love, I thought you knew. I'd never have... Rise waiting.
I am going to stay in my mum for a bit, but I was thinking on the way that just because I'm living at hers, don't mean that I can't stay at yours some nights. Especially when we've got classes in the morning. And speaking of which, you're cutting it a bit of fine, aren't you? History starts in half an hour.
I've been kicked out, Sharon.
Of college?
Yeah, and I've got other things in my life, haven't I? Like, better things.
Or like, working in the corner shop.
No.
Whoa. There's nothing wrong with Southpool.
Too late. Your breaking news has already been broken.
Yep. And I put a foot in it.
Sold the house, have we?
Cheryl and Lloyd have put in an offer and your dad's accepted. Sorry, sweetheart. It's not the end of the world.
I'm sorry, is there an echo in this place?
And I've made a start on finding us a new place.
Well, you see, that's good. Anywhere nice?
Well, it's early days yet, but I'm sure I will. You're all right, love. Well, I'd better get back to work. We'll talk about this tonight, OK?
I'll look after her.
Thanks, Sian. See you later.
Bye. Will be the end of the world, because I'll probably end up in some dingy bedsit or some high-rise hellhole.
Your mum!
Sian, she always going on about how she loves the countryside. What if she ends up in the middle of nowhere?
No, she's not going to do that to you.
Your mum did it. She moved miles away.
That was to be with you, Seth.
But what if she wants to live with Jeff?
Well, then it's a result in it, isn't it, Ned?
No, Sian, I don't want to live with a stranger. What about if we get our own place? Yeah, I'm being serious. I could ask Sunita for some more shifts. You could carry on at college. I could maybe even get another job. We could look round the Northern Quarter. It'd save us getting the train back and forward all the time. I'm going to look at some agencies. Just imagine it, Sian, our own little place, done to the way we like it.
All shabby and no chic. I've got a lesson in half an hour.
You go in college?
It's history.
Well, what happened to looking after me?
It's an hour's lesson.
I'll forget it.
So,
go, Sian, don't make yourself late.
How cute was you when you was little?
Yeah, well, not as cute as Chloe, obviously. You know Chloe, don't you? Your friend from holiday?
Chloe Hughes.
Yeah. So is this the reason why you saw off us getting a flat together? Because you're seeing another girl?
No. I'm off the idea of getting a flat because it's a silly pipe dream we could never afford.
I have got a job, Sian. Even if it's just in a corner shop.
Well, if I was seeing another girl, I'd make sure I told you first before I started advertising it on the internet.
Is that all you can say?
I text you all the time off my holiday. And I sent you postcards because I'm with you and I love you.
Yeah, well, you've got a funny way of showing it.
Why? Because I don't think it's cool to chuck my life away for a rubbish job in a dingy bedsit. Because, go on, you tell me what love is, Sophie.
Going along with every scheme that you dream up between pricing tins of beans.
Such a snob. Why is it? Do you think you're too good to do my job?
No, I think you're too good to do your job because it's a waste of your talents.
Don't try dressing it up, Sian. OK, if this Chloe ain't your girlfriend yet, she soon will be.
Well, if you carry on like this...
See? You're just as good as admitted it.
Oh,
do you know, you are mad. Go, Sian.
You can't be serious.
Yeah, well, I am. Go.
You are so going to regret this.
Sian, it's me. You just please call me back? Bye.
You know the house you sold?
Yeah.
Well, me and Jason are getting a flat together. And Dad's gonna help.
Well,
maybe you and Sean could do the same.
I doubt that one.
Well, I'm off to look at wallpaper. Mwah! Paper sale last year.
Send a notice. She's off her head.
Yeah, well, my mum's telling me we can barely afford a one-bedroom apartment.
Sophie, don't you start.
Start? What?
Trying to make me feel guilty.
I'm not!
Look, it was your mum who kicked me out in the first place. I didn't want to sell the house.
Look, I'm not trying to make you feel guilty, okay? It's just, I just want to talk.
Yeah, well, I've not got time to talk now. I'm late for the crash. I'll see you later.
I was just ringing you. Taxi's nearly here. Where's this from?
My mate, Sandra. Good.
Stupid thing.
Sophie. Hey, what's up, sweetheart? You're not yourself today. Hey.
What do you want? What's happening?
Make us a brew. Well, I thought you'd calmed down.
Did you?
You have sent me 3 messages.
Yeah, it was before I seen how much she was missing Chloe.
Why are you so paranoid? Well, maybe because you go on holiday, you come back and then you don't want to see me and spend the night. What's all that about?
Or maybe
because when I say, oh, let's get a house together, Sian, and you can't run away quick enough. That's not paranoia, Sian. That's you pushing me away.
Can you blame me?
You're a mess, Sophie. It used to be fun, and now I spend half my time trying to drag you out of bed and trying to make you do college work. Oh, until you got chucked out.
Start this again.
I'm sick of feeling more like your mum than your girlfriend. Stop nagging me then. Oh, do you know what? Forget it! What do you mean, forget it? Sian, are you had enough? So you're dumping me?
I can't take it anymore, Sophie.
What, so you're finishing it? I knew you was cheating. You're an idiot, do you know
Sophie?
That?
Sophie!
You can stick your poxy job on all.
There you are.
Yeah, here we are.
I went to the house looking for you.
No point going there anymore.
What's going on, Soph?
Well, I'm drinking cider. What are you going to do? Get me arrested?
Come on, let me tell
you. I don't want to go home.
Okay, then come to mine. Deb's in charge of the shop. He can do that a while longer.
Why? What's the point?
So we can talk.
I don't want to talk.
I'm worried about you.
Of course you are.
We all are.
Nobody cares about me anymore.
That is not true.
Not even God cares about me anymore.
Well, I don't know about
exactly.
God.
Exactly. You don't. So just leave it, yeah?
Sophie.
No! I don't want to come with you.
I am not leaving you like this.
Fine. I'll leave you then. See you in a bit.
Oh. Kevin.
Oh, yeah. Don't tell me your clutch is gone again.
No, it's fine. It's Sophie I've come about.
Oh, aye.
I think she's had a falling out, Sian.
I wouldn't worry about it. Two girls living together. You're bound to have arguments.
Well, she was really upset. She walked out on a shift and then I found her drinking.
Drinking?
I know it's not like her.
I told Sally.
Not yet.
I've got to pick Jack up from the crash, but I'll call around later. If she's okay.
I'm really worried.
Oh, call Sally.
Sophie?
The dyke and the sinner.
That's all for today. Off you go. Quickly, please.
Come on, you might as well join me.
Sophie, what's happened?
What has happened? What do you think's happened? God hates me. God hates me just like you said.
I never said that.
Yeah, you did. And he hates me because I'm gay.
God doesn't hate anyone.
Then why is he punishing me? Why is my life falling to pieces?
He isn't punishing you. Look, God sees your suffering.
You told me it was unnatural. And you told me that it was a sin if I acted upon my shameful desires.
Look, we're all sinners. But God loves us and he forgives us our human frailty.
give me all that love and forgiveness. God took everything away that I love. Everything. God doesn't care about me.
He does, Sophie, I promise.
Let's go and ask him, then, eh?
No, come on, sit down.
I don't want to listen to you. I want to hear from the man upstairs.
Sophie, come back.
Come on, then.
Sophie, come back.
I'm not asking for a thunderbolt or just a hint. Just give me a little hint.
Come on, it's not safe.
Did he say he would always protect his flock, eh? I shall give them eternal life that they shall never perish. Isn't that what John said?
Yes, but...
Right then. All as safe as houses, aren't I?
Come back, please.
Oh, I'm not part of his flock anymore. I'm a lost sheep.
Sophie, listen.
It's too late.
You were right about John. But do you remember Luke? Which of you men, if you had 100 sheep and one of them was lost, wouldn't leave 99 in the wilderness and go after the one that was lost until he found it? Come on. Give me a hand. Come back to us. We'll welcome you.
I can't change who I am.
He's not asking you to. I'm not asking you to. We accept you and love you for who you are. Sophie!
Coronation Street returns in half an hour.
Yes, she's breathing. Yes. Look, is an ambulance coming? Sophie. No response.
Hey, give me the keys.
I wasn't in the pub. I've told you I was sorting the baby.
Yeah, well, forgive me if I don't always trust you telling the truth.
I was.
It's not up for discussion.
Sophie Webster. She came in an ambulance. I'm her dad. Her mum's just parking.
Sophie...
Webster.
Mr. Webster. I'm Sophie's pastor.
What happened?
She fell from the church.
The church where?
The roof. It was an accident.
What have they said?
She's being examined now. I'll let the doctors know you're here.
Was she talking?
She was unconscious.
Is she all right?
I have to go and speak to the police, but I'll come back. Hello, Mrs. Webster. It was me who spoke to you.
Why was she on the roof?
The roof?
It wasn't intentional. She was... Well... She'd got emotional. Here, this is hers.
Dad, there's blood on it.
Look, I would have come looking sooner. I thought she'd gone home. I would have come looking sooner.
Mr. and Mrs. Webster?
Is Sophie okay?
She's gone for a CT scan and spinal x-rays.
A CT scan of what?
Her head, to check for any bleeding in the brain.
Brain damage?
We hope not. We'll know more once she's had the scan.
I want to see someone more senior.
Kevin, I think the more senior people are best stopping with Sophie. We're all doing our best for her, Mr. Webster, I promise. We'll know more soon.
Brain damage. What was she doing up there in the first place?
How would I know?
When you spoke to the pastor...
You heard. He just said it was an accident. I'm going to see what they're doing.
Hey, the doctor said she couldn't tell us if there was any news.
You saw her. She was hardly older than Rosie. What's she doing here?
Dad of anger. She's got a right to know.
Happy now?
Kevin?
Is she all right?
Oh, she would have been, if you hadn't got her in a right state.
What are you on about?
Rowing. No wonder Sophie went and got bladdered.
It wasn't like that.
Is that true?
Have you split up?
You knew about this. Is there anything else you're not telling me about Sophie, or is the drinking and the relationship meltdown about it?
I did tell you.
You did not.
Dad, I wouldn't have rang if you'd said. Look, it was just a row.
Oh, and Sophie just ended up hanging off a church roof.
Purpose?
She wasn't hanging off anywhere.
Is she all right or
you
what?
You said it was an accident.
Who did?
Well, if she had been drunk.
Well, if you'd gone straight to her when you knew she was drunk.
You didn't even know she'd go walkabout.
She wasn't walkabout.
So how come she's hanging off a church roof?
Oh, will you just stop it, please?
I'm sorry, love. You see what we've come to? Sophie could be dying for all we know, and all we can do is argue.
Oh, yeah, I will do as soon as we hear anything. All right, bye.
I didn't dump Sophie, you know.
She was upset over something.
She's always upset nowadays.
She doesn't always climb churches.
You think this is my fault? We had a row, that is all. We both said stuff.
Yeah, well, right now, I'm just bothered she's going to be all right.
Well, we should have said yeah to the flat.
What flat?
She asked us to move in together and I said no.
You're just kids?
It's not that. Because we'd end up in some cheap, run-down place. But then again, that's where she reckons her and Sally are going to end up and all.
No, they won't.
Yeah, and how do you know that? It just gets on top of her and then she has a go at me. And just because it's doing her head in, all the rows and not knowing what's going to happen. It's not her fault.
Like I said, I only care she's going to be all right.
Mr. Webster? The CT scan shows no bleeding in the brain and her neck and spine are okay. She's very lucky. Broken rib, fractured wrist, concussion. Could have been so much worse.
Thank you. Thanks, Doctor.
She needs to rest and we'll have to keep her in for observation. But you can see her.
I'll go and get Sally.
Please, will you tell her that I said I'm sorry? Please!
We're just glad you're okay.
It's amazing you're still with us. You are so precious to us.
Sian. Is there any news? Sian?
Just a hunch, but I don't think she wants to speak to you.
How's Sophie?
You're gonna blame me or not?
Right, look, she didn't break up with Sophie. They had an argument. She's explained it all to me.
Oh, no, I'll be glad we split up. So go on. What did you say to her?
Nothing. I tried to calm her, that's all.
Yeah, right. He's the one who says that we're sinners.
Oh, yeah. I forgot that was you.
He thinks we're scum.
Of course I don't.
You do. You said it to our faces.
I want you to be happy. Both of you.
But not together.
The best way to happiness is a true relationship with God.
But not with Sian.
What is wrong with loving someone? It's love.
Sian, I'm on your side.
No, you're not. Sophie could have died.
Can I? I wish you... could have been worse. A lot worse. She wants to see you.
Yeah.
Look, Sian, I'm sorry. I know none of this was your fault.
Have you heard what this guy's been saying to Sophie?
I'll go. You've got enough stress. I don't want to add to it.
Yeah, look, thanks for your help.
Yeah, I swear to you. I only want to help them find peace with themselves and with God.
I do not like him. Is she really okay?
Yeah. Tired.
Are you and Mum talking?
I'm sorry. I'll never let it kick off like this again. Come here. You're a good girl.
Is this on purpose?
No.
Tell me the truth.
And it's not my life to take.
Then what were you doing?
I don't know. I just need things to change.
You could have died, you know. You could be dead. I'd never go off with no one else, you know that. You know that I love you.
Do you?
So fair. You mustn't leave me ever, please.
I won't.
You okay?
Yeah.
Can I come back tomorrow? To hear you better after.
How are you doing?
Yeah, I'm just really tired.
You sleep. You're still my baby girl, you know?
Reminds me when we brought her home from hospital when she was a baby.
I was that tired that first year. I don't remember that much.
I do. Sat like this round the court. While you settle Rosa. I thought I'd be less scared of the second time. I still managed to convince myself if I stopped looking, she'd stop breathing.
It's now that's the worry. Teenage. I'd not do that again. Everything feeling like it's the end of the world. You argue with your boyfriend or your girlfriend.
It wasn't that, though, was it? She asked Sian to live with her.
Well, she does, pretty much. She did.
Get a flat together. Get away from all the rows and...
Are you trying to blame me?
No. It was all my fault. It's all my fault. I'm so sorry, Sophie.
Just a bit of sleep, but not too bad.
What's the latest?
They've said she can come home.
So soon?
In the next couple of days, hopefully. I'm dying for her to wake up and I can tell her.
I bet you are.
Oh, look at her.
Rosie, that nails key.
Oh, it was due to go in and wash that. It's got foundation all over it.
It'll do.
So?
Hey, Mum.
Hey, you little lazy bones.
Dad.
I jumped.
Well, that's what they say. Maybe it was a bit of both. I mean, I've never toppled off the top of a church roof. I know that for certain.
I mean, I've never even been on one.
But Jason says she's okay.
Well, because of the way she landed, all that praying's paid off.
Is anybody with her?
Well, the pasta was there, apparently. Oh, that reminds me, I need some tinned ravioli for our Jason's lunch.
I was thinking,
how can a grown man let a drunk 16-year-old girl barge past him, climb up onto a church roof and fall off?
Yeah, you're right, you know.
He was up on the roof with our daughter. Why didn't he bar away?
I want to know why she was three sheets to the wind in the first place.
Yeah, well, when the nurse has finished in there, we'll ask Sophie a few questions.
Those slippers you bought are Sian's, by the way.
Well, she was back at her mum's.
Well, people leave things places.
Oh, we'll ask Sian a few questions as well.
Oh, never too late to do some parenting, is it?
We're doing what we can. These are nice.
Why, because they're cheaper?
No, they're more like Sophie's colour.
What?
Well, they're like a new design.
A flower?
Yeah, didn't you hear they discovered a new kind?
And did they name them carnations?
Yeah. So the Brindle Street shop's fallen through.
Oh, it hasn't?
Yeah, the buyer, yeah, the death in the family, so the, everything's off.
Right. Well, okay. But this is Sophie we're talking about.
Yeah. How about these?
Do you know what? It's not true what people say about you.
Thanks, hon.
Oh, I love him.
Are you joking?
Yeah, it's funny.
So, has my mum and dad been grilling you, yeah?
Yeah.
My dad thinks the pastor should have stopped me getting on the roof.
Yeah, well, he's got a point. Oh, look at the state of that dress. How can she leave the house looking like that?
Sian, do you still love me?
Yeah.
You don't sound too sure.
Of course I'm sure.
I'm really sorry, you know.
Dad.
And just the thought of losing you.
Well, do you think your mum will let me move back in?
Are you serious?
Get some drink.
Because we fell out.
What about a girl?
Kind of. It was nothing, it was just some photos of someone that I met in Tangier.
And then what?
She overreacted. We had a row, and then I went back to my mum's. Look, I feel guilty enough as it is, Sally. This wasn't my fault, and I wasn't there when she started drinking, because if she was, I would have stopped her.
At last. You need a ball of string in this place.
Samita, they're beautiful.
Deb picked them out.
Is she asleep?
No, Kevin's in there with her.
I tried to see her home last night. I knew she was drunk. I should have made sure she got home.
No, it wasn't down to you. If one of us had known.
Well, I did mention it. Oh, it doesn't matter.
No, go on, you did mention it to who?
No, it's just, I told Kevin. He said he was busy.
Busy?
He had his baby to see to.
Is that what he said?
Well, he seemed to think, I don't want to get anybody in trouble.
Oh, I won't worry about that.
He said you'd deal with it.
He said what?
She's staggering round the street off her face and you're too busy to deal with it.
I was picking Jack up from the childminder. Where was you?
I didn't know what was going to happen, did I?
Neither did I.
Oh, Sally will deal with it. She nearly died because you couldn't be bothered with her. All you're bothered about is Jack.
I wish I hadn't said anything.
Yeah, well, he can't fend for himself, can he? She's virtually an adult.
She's 16. She's at the trickiest stage of her life.
Yeah, well, if you wasn't throwing yourself at blokes, she might have known where to look for you.
Yeah, if you hadn't gone off with Molly Dobbs, none of this would have happened.
I think I'm going to go...
I did what I could as fast as I could.
You have destroyed everything. Everything that we ever built up together, it's gone.
Oh, shut up, woman!
How dare you!
Yeah, well, I've had it up to here, Anna. I've apologised. I beg your forgiveness. But it is what it is. I've got a baby, you've got a bloke. Everything's changing. And some things get overlooked.
Yes, your daughter's by you.
And you?
Do you know what? I'm surprised that she didn't jump.
Excuse me?
Having used to as parents, I'm surprised she didn't jump.
Stay out of this, Sian, you're a little girl.
Don't you dare speak to her like that.
Well, one minute she's asking to move back in with us, and the next minute she's mouthing off.
No, I'm not mouthing off. For months now, everything she has been through, college and this, used to splitting up. None of us have been there for her and no one's told her that it's going to be okay.
Yeah, well, it isn't.
Dad?
I'm not being lectured to by a kid.
Yes, you are.
See, just listen to her. Talk to her, because everything that has been going on, you don't have a clue about. And then this is the result.
Sally, Kevin, I didn't mean to have a go like that before. I'm really sorry.
No, Sian, you hit home with what you said.
Things are going to be different from now on.
Sophie, I just wish you'd talk to me.
I tried to.
Oh, love.
If I was just too busy.
Never again. I promise.
Can I come in?
Yeah.
How are you feeling?
Yeah, I'm okay, thank you.
Well, thank God you're all right. So glad you're well.
Yeah.
And we do have to thank him.
I know. Do you think it was a miracle?
Well, it's not every day that a girl falls from that height and comes out unscathed.
Yeah.
God loves you, Sophie.
Do you think he's given me a second chance?
A chance to learn, to change, yes, I sincerely do. Chance we've all been given, actually. Well, better be going.
Okay. Thanks for coming.
Sophie.
Yes.
I wondered if you and Sian might consider coming back to choir.
Are you sure?
Yeah. I think it gives us a chance to work things out. We've all missed you.
Yeah, we've missed it too.
So you consider it?
Definitely.
I'm glad.
Thank you.
You all right?
I'm glad you could make it.
Hey, don't have a go, all right?
Oh, Sophie.
She's all right.
I was only being nice. That's me all over, though, innit, eh? Mr. Nice Guy. And we all know what happens to them.
I'm sorry, I've got to go. Hey, Sophie. Hey, you late now, then?
No, I'm a hologram.
Oh, this is brilliant.
It's good, isn't it?
Oh, do I get a hug?
Sophie, come inside. It's cold.
It's feeling a bit now.
Bye, love.
You're a walking miracle.
Yeah, but I don't need looking after.
Sophie, I can't go to work. I can't leave you.
Mum, I feel fine. I'm not an invalid.
Oh, have you heard this?
I know. All right, my ribs are sore. Oh
my God, it wasn't a convertible.
But you are fine to go to work and leave me with her.
Her? Oh, thanks.
You are fine to go to work and leave me with Sian.
Sophie, I meant what I said in the hospital. I want to be here for you every step of the way. And if that means taking time off work, then so be it.
And that's love for you if you sell it. And it's off.
Yeah, I know.
But I'm sure you'd have to be here 24/7.
Well, if I did go back to work... You would make sure she takes it easy, wouldn't you?
Of course I will.
Mum, I've got my own personal slave now. I'm not moving for no one, baby.
How's she doing?
Well, she says her ribs hurt, but she was adamant I came in. Sian's keeping an eye on her, but I did say I'd take time off, but...
You're doing a cracking job.
Am I? I don't feel I am, or else she wouldn't have done what she did.
Can we talk?
What are we doing now, singing?
About what happened, about us.
Kevin, there is no us. Sophie's all that matters now.
How's work?
Oh, you know, same old, same old. Hey, everyone was asking about you, you know. You're much better thought of than you give yourself credit for.
Well, they probably are being nice to your face. Wait till our backs are turned, they're probably calling us all sorts.
Oh, Sophie, you are so glass half empty sometimes. People can just be nice, you know.
Yeah, right. Who do you think that is?
Probably your dad. Do you want to see him?
Yeah, if you don't mind.
Of course I don't mind. I'd never stop you seeing your dad. I know how much he means to you. Jeff!
Hiya. Hiya, you. How are you?
I'm all right, thank you.
Rosie told me about, so I thought I'd pop round and...
Oh, well, that's very sweet of you, Jeff, honestly, but...
I just wondered if you need a hand with anything. I can do shopping, cleaning. I might draw the line at wiping snot, though.
No, I mean, we're ship-shape and honeymoon fresh, so...
Right.
Maybe you could take my mum out for a drink.
Sophie?
What?
You can't say things like that.
I'll behave.
Oh, if that's going to make Sophie feel better, could you manage one? A little one.
I can't leave Sophie.
Mum, Sian is upstairs. I'm not dying.
Oh, okay. Well, I could have a little one. I'll go and change my top. Make yourself comfy.
Thanks.
Ooh, very nice.
50 chains, there, Glassell.
Thanks, Sean.
Thanks, cheers, Sean.
Coming right up.
Can I get you a white wine?
No, you're all right, Kevin. Shall we sit down, Jeff?
Oh, so you've left our sick daughter on her own so you can come out with your new boyfriend. Very supportive, yeah?
Actually, shall we go to the Worthy Arms?
Yeah.
For your information, me coming out with Jeff was Sophie's idea. And our sick daughter, as you call her, is sat in with her very nice girlfriend who's more than capable of keeping an eye on her.
Well, you've changed your tune. Don't seem 5 minutes ago since you hated the idea of her being a lesbian.
I'm dealing with it. And you deal with this.
What?
You're going to hear back from my solicitor because I'm going to speak to him tomorrow. So keep your eye on the post. Have a nice night, Kevin. On your own.
Smart.
Oh, well, I've got an appointment straight after work, so...
It's not a hospital, is it? It's not come back, has it?
No, of course not. I'm going to see the solicitor about the divorce.
Oh.
Is that okay?
Yeah, of course.
You sure?
Mum, it's fine. I'm fine with it, honestly.
All right, I better get off. Take good care of her.
I will.
See you later.
Bye.
Hi there. Hiya. Just come to see how the invalid is.
Yeah, I'm okay.
Yeah, as long as you don't laugh.
Well, I won't tell you any jokes.
You never used to find your jokes funny anyway.
Oh, charming. So where's your mum?
She's at work. Hey, you know the college? They're letting Sian study at home until I'm better.
It's good of them.
So you're going to this appointment now, then?
What appointment?
My mum's gone to see the solicitor today about the divorce.
Right.
Sorry, Dad, I thought you knew.
Yeah, I think she did mention something about it. How do you feel about it?
Well, yeah, okay, I suppose. I mean, if it's gonna happen, I might as well just get on with it.
I suppose you're right. Sophie said you was gonna go to the solicitor.
Yeah, that's right, I did tell you.
Yeah, I know, but I thought you'd change your mind. I thought we agreed to put Sophie first.
Well, Sophie's fine with it.
Come on, we know she's putting on a brave face. It's all this what pushed her to the edge in the first place.
No, it's all this. Us, at each other's throats. So I suggest that you stop kicking off and you get on with this in a civilised manner. Before I decide anything, I think we should decide who's getting what. So just make sure you're there with your solicitor.
Don't get knocked at me, right, but are you sure you're all right with your dad in this divorce? Yeah, I'm fine. Honest. Feels weird, you know, but it's like I've got your back.
It's because you have.
I know who I am again. Oh, well, that falls certainly not some sense into you, did it?
Whatever. Could say that. Or you could call it a miracle.
Oh, are you serious?
Hello, I survived, didn't I?
Through blind luck, Soph.
Whatever. I needed a wake-up call. Because a few days ago, I was so mad at everyone. At you. And at him. And now, I look back and I think, what was all the fuss about?
And you think he made that happen?
No, I think gravity made that happen. I just think God chipped in at the end and helped with the landing.
And you really believe that?
All I know is I'm alive and I've got you.
Hi, come in. Sal is here!
Well, how are you?
Yeah, I'm getting better, thanks.
Glad to hear it. No more climbing on roofs, eh?
No, my feet are staying firmly on the ground.
That's about to fall.
Hello, Jeff. Sorry to keep you waiting.
You haven't.
Right, I shan't be late, girls. So, see you later.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye, Jeff.
Bye, Jeff.
Right, girls, I've been thinking. Oh, don't tell Jason, you're worrying. But are you trying to imply that Jason fit? But as if he's perfect for you.
Yeah, we do make an A-list couple, don't we?
Yeah, well, that's not what you've been thinking about, right?
No, that's me.
What about it?
Right, look, I'm all for Mum getting half of it.
Yeah, yeah, me too.
But it's best not to let Dad know about that. Do you know what I mean?
Oh, Mum!
Morning.
Morning, thank you.
Wow, somebody's out to impress.
And he's succeeded. Makes Monday mornings so much better.
Bacon butter usually does that for me, but hey, I'm easily impressed. See you later.
See ya. Are they from Jess? Have you
told him about Dad's last shooting?
No, Rosa, because not everybody thinks like you.
Well, you just don't know who you can trust, do you?
He's your agent! Oh.
Well, as a matter of fact, I haven't told anybody, but it's nice of you to worry about me.
Yeah, exactly.
That is a serious bouquet.
Isn't it? And they're my favourite flowers. Oh! Hello, it's Sally Webster. Oh, Jane, thanks for ringing me back.
All right, come on. Why are we not allowed to talk to Dad about the money situation?
Well, just in case Mum isn't entitled to half, then Dad gets all of it.
Well, duh.
Yeah, so it's best to stay on his right side, isn't it?
Rosie, that's being a bit disloyal to Mum, don't you think?
Oh, why?
Because we should be encouraging my dad to do the right thing and not try to take advantage.
Oh, Sophie. You know, sometimes I don't even know that you're my sister. The things that go on in your head.
Ah, that was my solicitor, and she's talked about the money.
Yeah, so's Rosa.
Right, I better get back to work.
Mum, I won't come here.
Rosie! I put these in water then, shall I?
I will take those.
Sean, my arm is fine. I get this stuck off today.
You still need to be careful.
Okay.
You'd be better off learning to juggle with something a little bit smaller. Cereal boxes take years of practice.
Thank you.
Pleasure.
So you're in here to buy something?
Well, that's what usually happens. People come in to buy things.
£1.15, please. What?
It was a 20. You've only given me change for a 10.
No.
Yeah. Sorry.
Oh, please, don't tell me this always works for you.
This?
Oh, you come in, see the till girl, give her what you think's a killer smile, and then play the, oh, I'll give you a £20 note stunt.
If I wasn't £10 out of pocket, I'd be flattered.
What?
But you think my smile is good enough to leave girls weak at the knees and charm money out of the till?
Oh, please, there's only one person here that fancies you and it is not me.
Say the same to you, but that'd be rude. I'm still a tenner down. Problem?
There's no £10 notes.
No £10 notes. So I couldn't give you one.
Which means your change will have to be in coins. £10.
Thank you. This is the killer smile you were talking about. Any chance of an apology? No? Just check in. See you later.
Hopefully not.
Hello?
Hello. Are you looking for Tyrone?
Yeah, do you know him?
Yeah, well, he's either going to be in the garage or it'll be in the cafe having his dinner.
Cafe is...
Porridge Poles, it's around the corner. I'm going there myself so I could tell him that you're looking for him if you want.
Cheers, that's really kind of you.
Thank you.
Yeah, even so, thanks. I'll try the garage then.
See you later then.
That'd be nice. I was hoping I'd find you here.
I thought it was when we're looking for Tyrone.
Yeah, about myself for a friendly face. Nothing on the ground round here.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, the only one who's giving me the time of day. Bloke in the garage gave me a mouthful, and then the girl in the shop right stropping there.
Really?
Yeah, she shortchanged me, and then accused me of trying it on with her. But yeah, boyfriend.
Shall I got one?
Explains everything. What about you?
Nope.
I'll
say that. Are you ordering anything? Because it's starting to make me think you're some kind of stalker.
Stalker. Hopeless romantic. It's all in the eyes of the beholder. But I just thought I could help you.
You can help me.
You look tense. But I've been in Thailand lately. I've learned shed loads about alternative therapy and all that.
I've heard about sort of therapy books. Get out there, thank you.
That, I'm serious. Healing hands, these. 5 minutes work wonders.
Who for?
Look, I only need your palm. I'll give you some reflexology. Come on, what have you got to lose? Give me your hand.
I swear, if there's any funny business, you'll be getting the other one and all right across the face.
Understood. Oh, yeah. Yeah, definitely.
What?
Got a blockage in your chi.
What, is that bad?
It's not good. Your chi is your life force, your mojo, you get up and go.
Well, do you know what? I might just do that. Am I meant to be feeling something?
Believe me, give it time. You will. But just relax.
Going on?
Do you mind? This is a private session. Do one.
Hey, don't talk to my kid like that.
You're a dad. My guest.
Sian.
He's Tyrone's mate. He's only messing.
Yeah, well, I'd appreciate if you didn't mess with my girlfriend.
You mean you two?
Yes.
What a waste.
What?
Did you hear that? Pure homophobia there.
Ick. It's not a comment on your sexuality, love. It's a comment on you.
Hey, you looking for a slap? Say you're sorry. Or else we're taking this outside.
Dad, leave it. I can fight my own battles.
Look, I'm not after any trouble.
Too late. You found it.
Oh, Tyrone's over there, I think.
You better. And stay out of my way, if you know what's good for you.
Nice guy.
Oh, you don't know the half of it, mate.
Are you Tyrone Dubs?
Who's asking?
Look, am I glad to see you. Tommy Duckworth, Jack's grandson. Is he about?